If 6 is less than the absolute value of x minus 3, which is less than 7, and x is equal to 0, what is one possible value of the absolute value of x? So let's just rewrite this first compound inequality, and then we'll think about this constraint of x being less than 0. So they're telling us that 6 is less than the absolute value of x minus 3, which is less than 7. So let's just think about what it means to take an absolute value. An absolute value of an expression or of a number could be viewed as, well, how far is that number away from 0? For example, we've seen this before, negative 5 is 5 away from 0. 5 is 5 away from 0. So if you think about it that way, and now let's draw a number line and visualize, where would x minus 3 sit? Where are all the possible places where x minus 3 could sit? And I'm going to try to draw a pretty big number line so that we can visualize it reasonably well. So let's say that this right over here is 0. This is positive 6. This is positive 7. Positive 7. And this is negative 6. Negative 6. And this is negative 7. So if x minus 3 sits in this interval between 6 and 7, and not equaling those because these aren't less than or equal, these are just less than signs. So if x minus 3 is in this interval between 6 and 7, so if x minus 3 is there, then the absolute value of x minus 3 is going to be between 6 and 7 away from 0. But the other place where x minus 3 could be is in this interval between negative 6 and negative 7. X minus 3 could also be there. Because anything here, if you take any value in that interval right over there, its absolute value, its distance from 0, it's between 6 and 7 away from 0. Notice, something over here would be, so for example, negative 6.2. That is between 6 and 7 away from 0. So this is the absolute value, the distance of this distance to the left, if we're thinking about this area, and it's the distance to the right of 0 if we're thinking about things in this interval. So what are the two situations? Well, this blue situation is just 6 is less than x minus 3, which is less than 7. We're essentially assuming that x minus 3 is positive. But then there's the case where x minus 3 could be negative. And in that case, we have negative 7. Negative 7 is going to be less than x minus 3. X minus 3, which is going to be less than negative 6. So these are the two cases. And to figure out what x would be in each of these cases, we could add 3 to all three parts of this inequality. So if you add 3 to 6, you get 9. Is less than, add 3 here, that's the whole point, the 3 and the negative 3 cancel out, is less than x, and then less than 7 plus 3 is 10. So that's one possibility. The other possibility over here, if you add 3 to all the different parts of this compound inequality, negative 7 plus 3 is negative 4, is less than x minus 3 plus 3 is x, which is less than negative 6 plus 3 is negative 3. Now, so if this was our only constraint, this is what we would know about x, that either this is true or this is true. But then they tell us another constraint. They tell us that x is less than 0. So x can't be greater than 9, so we can rule out this case, which pretty much rules out that case, and makes us focus on this case. X has to be less than 0. So what's one possible value of the absolute value of x? Well, you can pick any x in this interval between negative 3 and negative 4. You could say, well, x could be equal to negative 3.1. You could say x is equal to negative 3.01. You could say x is equal to negative 3.56. You could say x is equal to negative 3.99. All of these x's are in this interval. So one possible value, well, we could just say, well, let's just say x is equal to negative 3.5. You take the absolute value of x, so then the absolute value of x would be equal to positive 3.5. And we are done.